Hi, this is Vijay Chandrasekhar from the ECE batch of 2002. So as part of this session, we're looking at throwing some light on how to create resumes. So it'll be more of a discussion format. We have two other participants on this call. Let me introduce you to T. Vidya. T. Vidya, can you just introduce yourself?
Hi, this is Vidya. So I'm as well from the 2002 batch from GCT. And I've been a technical writer, then been with Accenture for 11 years. Now I'm here to make this platform live where the alumni and the current GCT students can connect, stay connected, and we learn from each other.
Chandran, would you like to say something about yourself?
Hello everyone, I'm Hemachandran from the Department of CUC, currently studying in third year. I'm a peer of my class, and I just wanted to help out the placement preparation going on, and I like the initiative done by our alumni. So I just wanted to contribute myself in this development progress.
All right, thank you. So today we're going to discuss about resumes. Okay. Allow me to pose a question to you. What do you think a resume is? And feel free to answer in Tamil or English, you know, whichever language you're comfortable. Okay, so there's no barrier as far as language is concerned. So what do you think a resume is? Just your take.
Yes, sir. In my point of view, a resume is something which shows what we are and what kind of person we are. In spite of the person, the personality decide for the chances from being also maybe the technical HR rounds munadi poradanaala nammalo technical skills enna appdi solittu recruiter kandipa purinjikkuvanga. In case avanga nam resume paakumbodhu nammudaiya enna personality enna nam endha vishayatha reveal panna nenikrom endha vishayatha hide panna nenikrom appingiradhu avanga vandu purinjikkuradhukku oru nalla scope tharadhu indha resume dhaan sir.
Okay, neenga vandhu ipo ஒரு ரெசியூமே வச்சு ஒரு இன்டர்வியூ எந்த டைரக்ஷன்ல போறதுன்னு டிசைட் பண்ண முடியும்னு நினைக்கிறீங்களா? What is your take on that?
If there is a lot of pre-preparation, sir.
Can you just elaborate on that? What do you mean by that?
Yes, sir. ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் நம்ம இப்போ ஏதோ ஒரு ப்ளே பண்ண போறோம் அப்படின்னா அதுக்கு முன்னாடி ஒரு ரிஹர்ஸ் பண்ணிப்போம் இல்லையா? ரெக்ரூட்டர் கிட்ட போயிட்டு நம்மளுடைய ஒரு ஜாப் ஆஃபர் நம்ம செக் பண்ணி பார்க்க போறோம் அப்படின்னா கண்டிப்பா நம்ம ரிஹர்ஸ் பண்ணுவோம். ஸோ நம்ம ரிஹர்ஸ் பண்ண போற விதம் வந்து எப்படி இருக்கணும் அப்படின்னா, இந்த மாதிரி குவெஷன்ஸ்லாம் நம்ம ரெக்ரூட்டர் நம்ம கிட்ட குவெஷன் பண்ணலாமா, இந்த மாதிரி குவெஷன்ஸ்லாம் நம்ம கிட்ட ஷூட் பண்ணலாமா, நாம அவர்கிட்ட என்ன கேட்கலாம், அவர் என்ன கிட்ட நம்ம கேட்கலன்னு சொல்லிட்டு ஒரு பிரெயின் ஸ்டார்ம் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா நம்ம கண்டிப்பா என்னென்ன கேட்கலாம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு கிடைச்சிடும் சார். ஸோ அதை வச்சு நாமளே ஸ்கிரிப்ட் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா வி குட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆர் வி குட் கிராக் வாட் ஹவு த இன்டர்வியூ வில் பி.
Okay, so neenga solrapadi, if I'm understanding you right, what you're trying to say is or resume namm eludradha vechu you can actually script your interview nu neenga solla varinga, adhaadu or interview endha direction la povano nradhu neenga mudivu pannalam appdi neenga solla varinga, am I right?
Yes sir, not everyone but
or question.
Sure sir, pandrom nam check panni paak porom appdina kandippa nam rehearse pannuvom. So nam rehearse panna pora vidham vandu eppdi irukum appdina, இந்த மாதிரி குவெஷன்ஸ்லாம் நம்ம ரெக்ரூட்டர் நம்ம கிட்ட குவெஷன் பண்ணலாமா, இந்த மாதிரி குவெஷன்ஸ்லாம் நம்ம கிட்ட ஷூட் பண்ணலாமா, நாம அவர்கிட்ட என்ன கேட்கலாம், அவர் என்ன கிட்ட நம்ம கேட்கலன்னு சொல்லிட்டு ஒரு பிரெயின் ஸ்டார்ம் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா நம்ம கண்டிப்பா என்னென்ன கேட்கலாம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு கிடைச்சிடும் சார். ஸோ அதை வச்சு நாமளே ஸ்கிரிப்ட் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா வி குட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆர் வி குட் கிராக் வாட் ஹவு த இன்டர்வியூ வில் பி.
ஓகே, ஸோ நீங்க சொல்றபடி இஃப் ஐ அம் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் யூ ரைட், வாட் யூ ட்ரைங் டு சே இஸ் ஒரு ரெஸ்யூமே நம்ம எழுதுறத வச்சு யூ கேன் ஆக்சுவலி ஸ்கிரிப்ட் யுவர் இன்டர்வியூ நீங்க சொல்ல வரீங்க, அதாவது ஒரு இன்டர்வியூ எந்த டைரக்ஷன்ல போகணும்ன்றது நீங்க முடிவு பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்னு நீங்க சொல்ல வரீங்க, அதான் ரைட்?
எஸ் சார், நாட் எவரி
ஒரு க்வெஸ்சன்.
சியா சார்,
பண்றோம்னு வச்சுக்கங்களேன், வாட் இஸ் த கீ? சி, இஃப் யூ திங்க் அபவுட் இட், ஒரு ரெசியூமே எடுக்கிறீங்க அஸ் அ ரெக்ரூட்டர், ஐ பிக் அப் அ ரெசியூமே, சரிங்களா?
ஓகே சார,
இப்ப நாலு பேஜ் இருக்குன்னு வச்சுக்காங்க ரெசியூமே, டு யூ திங்க் இட் மேக் சென்ஸ்? வாட் இஸ் த டேக் ஆன் தட்?
நோ சார்.
யே,
ஒரு நாலு பேஜஸ் கொண்டு போன அப்படின்னா ஒரு 2 மார்க் க்வெஸ்சனுக்கு ஒரு 10 மார்க் ஆன்சர் எழுதுற மாதிரி சார். சோ இட் ஹஸ் நோ வர்த், இட் ஹஸ் a lot of content to be said. Sorry sir.
Yeah, so we kind of understood what you were trying to say. So what you're trying to say is it makes sense for a resume to be just a single page, correct? ஒரு பேஜ்ல வந்து resume முடிக்கிறதுல, right? But what do you think is the reason why it should be one page, why not say 3 pages? இது என்னோட பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ சொல்றேன். you might think about it, you know, whether it makes sense.
Yes, sir.
See, typically, paathana, or recruiter oda attention span irukku. You know, or paper eduthana,
yes, sir.
Just scan through it. That's it. Sariya. Very rarely would people go around turning pages to see what is there. Sariya. So, and the first few seconds, sir, in my view, is very, very important. அவங்க கண்ணுக்கு என்ன படுது இல்ல அந்த லேடியோ ஜென்டில்மேன் ஹோம்ஸ் ஓவர் இட் இஸ் அவங்க கண்ணுக்கு என்ன படுதுன்றது இட் கம்ஸ் வெரி வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ரைட் ஸோ ஐ திங்க் ஹேவிங் இட் இன் ஒன் பேஜ் மேக்ஸ் அ லாட் ஆஃப் சென்ஸ் பிகாஸ் இட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் கேப்சர்ஸ் ஒரு பேஜ்ல வந்து ஃபைவ் செகண்ட்ஸோ த்ரீ செகண்ட்ஸோ வாட் எவர் இஸ் அதில் அது ஒரு பேஜ்ல கொடுத்துட்டோம்னா தென் தேர்ஸ் அ பெட்டர் சான்ஸ் ஃபார் அஸ் டு ரியலி கைட் தி இன்டர்வியூ இன் த டைரக்ஷன் தட் யூ வாண்ட் டு கைட் இட் ரைட் வித்யா வுட் யூ ஹேவ் அ பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ ஆன் திஸ்
Definitely. So generally when when I had done staffing for my teams as well, I only look at their skills. The first page where they talk about their skills. Achievements, I look at the achievement section to see how they've been doing. But these are the two main sections that I will generally look at. I don't go through what projects they have done. They are all secondary. First of all, the skills have to match depending on the demand that we have. And அதுக்கப்புறம் அவங்க அச்சீவ்மெண்ட்ஸ் பார்ப்பேன் ஸோ ஜென்ரலி ஹவு தே ஒர்க் எப்படி அவங்க ஆட்டிடியூட் ஏதாவது இருக்கா அதை பற்றி ஏதாவது இருக்கா அப்படின்றதுக்காக ஐ லுக் அட் தட் போர்ஷன் தட்ஸ் இட் ஆக்சுவலி ஐ டோன்ட் ரீட் த என்டையர் ரெஸ்யூமே ஸோ தட்ஸ் மை
அப்சல்யூட்லி ரைட் இன்னொரு இது அகைன் இது வந்து அகைன்ஸ்ட் யுவர் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ஐ திங்க் இட் மேக்ஸ் அ லாட் ஆஃப் சென்ஸ் டு போல்ட் ஆர் ஹைலைட் சர்டன் கீவேர்ட்ஸ் in your resume. So for example, when there for your resume there is a bunch of text there na few keywords if you manage to highlight it I think that could be fantastic because what will happen is or a recruiter when there and the word correct or palichu theriyum the recruiter right and it might take them in a particular direction so for example so on paran profile summary in a section typically resume right and the profile summary la you define yourself in a nutshell யார் நீ அப்படின்றத ஒரு நக்ஷல்ல நீ டிஃபைன் பண்ற ரைட் ஸோ அதுல பார்த்தேன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க டிபிக்கலி நிறைய அட்ஜெக்டிவ்ஸ் எல்லாம் நம்ம இன்க்ளூட் பண்ணலாம் ஸோ ஐ கால் மை செல்ஃப் அன் இனோவேட்டர் அ லீடர் அப்படின்ற மாதிரி சொல்லுவேன் அப்புறம் சே அ ஸ்ட்ராங் அகாடமிக் பர்ஃபார்மர் ஸோ வி கைண்ட் ஆஃப் டிஸ்கிரைபிங் யுவர் செல்ஃப் இன் அ ஃபியூ வேர்ட்ஸ் ரைட் இப்போ இந்த வேர்ட்ஸ் வந்து லெட்ஸ் சே யூ மேனேஜ் டு ஹைலைட் இட் சம் பீப்புள் டோன்ட் ஹைலைட் இட் பட் லெட்ஸ் சே யூ மேனேஜ் டு ஹைலைட் இட் ரைட் So there's a chance that when you highlight it, you can steer the interview in a certain direction. Sorry, oh, innovator, enna ipdi perusa innovate panna? Why do you call yourself an innovator? Abindra mari kekkalam. Illa leader ani, why do you call yourself a leader? Academic performer, abindra vanga one academic section la paapanga. Oh, 12th level score, you know, 10th level score, your engineering level score, abindra. Right? So I think by highlighting certain keywords in the resume, there is a chance that you could steer it in the direction that you want.
So any small achievement, it can be big or small, let's not decide on that, but even any small achievement, let's assume you have arranged for a trip to Ooty. You led the whole trip, okay, working with the staff, the students, which means your friends and the vendors, okay. So even that small thing can be highlighted. For example, led a trip of 200 students to Ooty shows that you are capable of coordinating and leading a team that large, right? So even such small achievements can be highlighted, definitely. When it comes to the technical side, if you have done some certifications, any kind of self-reading, self-learning, maybe you did a course, going through some webinars or course in Coursera, it is worth mentioning it in the resume. You may not be an expert in it, but still you have a knowledge or at least the basic knowledge on what it is all about.
Okay.
Little doubt in it, sir.
Yeah.
What if a student does a course, online course, but he doesn't acquire the certificate for it?
Hey, you can say completed the course. You don't say certified. It's all about usage of words. Right, so you don't need to say Coursera certified in machine learning. You don't need to say that. You can say completed machine learning course in Coursera, something like that, right? So it's all about using right? So now, there is a very pertinent point that Vidya raised, which was even the smallest of things can be highlighted. I'll tell you why I think it is important. Because see, in a typical campus, like say GCT, in a class of say 60 students, take computer science for that matter, you will probably have some 5 or 10 achievers, you know, who have done paper presentations, or you know, who have good scores, good ACADs, so on and so forth, right? Now the question is, what about the rest? Now they may not have strong credentials, right? But does it mean that their resume has to be poor? So how should they construct their resumes becomes very important, right? So my view is, you can probably add, my view is, such people should look into their personalities. I'm pretty sure there are many things about themselves that they could portray, right? So even something as trivial as say, you know, you go around, you participated in a campaign where you cleaned up the campus. You know, it could be as simple as that, right? Now that could be portrayed, you know, under, you know, you could, if you want to call it Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, you know, nobody stops you from doing that, right? So, so even such trivial things become very, very important. So, or let's say you, I think maybe T. Vidya, can you just open that presentation? Exactly, right. Now, this is a good example, right? Now, if you think about it, right, when it comes to skills, now, not everybody may be very skillful, right? But pretty much everybody would know a Microsoft Word or Microsoft Excel. So, you know, tools can always be there on your resume. Likewise, management skills. There are a variety of management skills, right? So, you may not be good or you may not have experience in everything, but then I'm pretty sure you probably have some experience in conflict resolution, right? I mean, to put it in a very crude term, conflict resolution is panchayat control, nothing else, right? So if you've done that and provided you can justify that in an interview, or you could put that as well, right? And likewise, interpersonal. Everybody has some sort of interpersonal skills, correct? So, so the point that I'm trying to make is, even those who are not, who don't consider themselves to be very skilled, when I say skilled in terms of hard skills, they can also come up with a good resume provided they understand themselves really well and they project themselves well, right?
Let's assume you have done your complete schooling in a Tamil medium or something like that, okay? And engineering is your first English education, okay? So, and if you had sort of coped up with it and sort of, I mean, you have coped up with it, right? So you're in your second year or third year already. So that is worth mentioning, okay? So, I mean, coming from a complete Tamil or some other medium and learning engineering in English is not a trivial thing. So these are things that are worth mentioning.
Yeah, yeah. T. Vidya raises a very interesting point. So, for example, when it comes to achievements, right, we typically put hard achievements on our resume. You know, won a competition here, won a competition there, so on and so forth. But then, something as trivial as, say, I have improved my English skills over the last 3 years. That in itself is an achievement, right? Provided you're able to justify it, right? You'll have to back it up. But then, if you're able to back it up, then that in itself can be an achievement, right? So, the whole idea is to look into yourselves and try to figure out the positives in you, what you've done over the last several years. And then try to structure it in a way that can be sold in a resume. I think that's the key. Any thoughts?
Doubt in here, sir. Mm-hmm. As I have said, for a layman, what if a student has an abundance of data? He has a lot of data, and he wanted to apply for a job of a developer. Can you get me, sir?
Yeah. Go ahead.
What if a student has a lot of data, lot of skills to be put in it, and he wanted to apply for a job of developer, he must have, there is no need for applying any irrelevant information like working in MS Office or Photoshop and any other like that.
Absolutely. You have a point. So ideally speaking, you could have multiple resumes. You don't need to have one single resume, right? So maybe it may not apply for a computer science guy, but let's say you're a mechanical engineer and you wish to apply to a mechanical company, maybe an automobile company and a software company. So ideally, you should have two resumes, you know, one that suits a mechanical firm, right? And another one that suits a software firm, right? So for example, in your IT case, if you're super skilled, then, you know, you shouldn't be talking about Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, etc., right? You should be talking more about algorithms, you know, programming languages that you have knowledge of, or maybe you would have won a competition here, a competition there. Maybe you have a profile on GitHub, or you have all your content there, right? Or maybe you participated in the Hacker Rank competition, something like that. Right? So those things become very, very important. So customize it. That's very, very important.
It is better to keep them handy. Yeah, keep them handy for different
Absolutely.
Kinds of
Correct.
Companies. So
Correct.
Depending on Exactly. the nature of the company and the job or the role, generally it is better to have one version for the IT companies and one for a mechanical or an electronics company. Three versions
or even civil for that matter.
Yeah.
Civil, IBT, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
So you are a computer science guy, so it cannot apply to you. But for the rest, definitely you could have one for your core area and then one for IT. It makes a lot of sense, right?
Okay.
And the other key point is most of the resumes that at least I have seen have spelling mistakes, grammatical errors, title case is wrong, things like that. I mean, that gives a very bad impression. You will not feel like further reading or going through the resume. So it is a very important thing that we actually proofread, correct the errors, and then give it to whomsoever. So that is like the first time you see something wrong, you will feel like not going further with the resume.
Is there any technical solution for it, ma'am, such as a Grammarly software?
Yeah, you can, but Word actually gives you better options. I think that is more than enough to correct your errors, any sentence formation or any grammatical errors.
See, another thing you could do is have your resume proofread by multiple people. That might
By your peers, yes.
Right.
They will give you a view, right? Because we write the resume. So because we write a resume and we may have some thoughts in our mind, but the person who's reading it may think, can understand it differently. So that may be the right perspective also. So it is better to ask your friends to read through and check with them whether it sounds right for them.
See, another thing is, we have a strong mentorship program running, right? So you could send it to your mentor, alumni mentor, you know, who could have a look at it. You know, he or she may have a point of view.
It's a great idea. It's a right, so.
Right? So that can also be done. So whenever you create resumes, right, just make sure that multiple eyes look at that resume before it actually goes to a recruiter.
Yes, sir.
Right? Okay.
And the other thing that happens is try to convert it into a PDF and share it before.
Yes, ma'am. That's a notable
because,
point.
Because sometimes there are agents who sort of work between the recruiter and the candidate and they sort of manipulate things as well. So that has happened real time. Okay. So you need to sort of ensure that it's converted to PDF before you circulate to anybody.
Okay, of course. When she talks of PDF, we're talking of a case where you're just sending a resume, you know, your company is not visiting the campus, you're not physically presenting your resume.
Correct, right?
Another reason why PDF makes sense is because Word, at times, it depends on your application. Right? So your format can go completely haywire, right? You open a particular resume on your mobile, it will look very different as compared to opening it on a desktop. But PDFs,
the alignment gets changed.
Yes, absolutely. Correct. But PDFs, the advantage is it's consistent. You know, it doesn't matter where you open it. It
yes, sir.
Look fine, right? So it kind of makes sense to have it converted.
In PDF.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, sir.
Right. So any further thoughts? Is it a hard stop now?
Another thing we see that we missed maybe is we were saying we have to bring in any achievement, I mean, any strengths of the institution, right? For example, when we talk about GCT, right? I think you had a point on that.
Oh, yes, of course. So one thing is, see, you're not just selling yourself, you're also selling an institution. That's also very important, right? So for instance, we are ranked 25th on perception, and this was in 2018 though. If you look at the NIRF ranking, we were ranked 25th on perception in 2018, which is pretty high. So
amongst all the engineering colleges, right?
Yes, amongst all engineering colleges in India. We were ahead of a few IITs as well. Some of the more recent IITs, we were ahead of them, right? At least on perception. So there are certain positive aspects that we can portray on the resume as well about the institution, right?
So, Maina, what NIRF is?
Yeah, National Institute Ranking Framework. That's right. So, it's an all-India ranking ranked by the Ministry of HRD. Quite popular for engineering, management, arts, etc. And these days, it's kind of becoming a de facto standard for ranking. So, everybody sells their NIRF ranking. So, what institutes do is they submit their data
to standardized. The Ministry of
HRD. Yes, it's standardized. Quite standardized. And they've been doing it for the past 3 years. GCT has also been submitting their data to the Ministry of HRD. So we were ranked 90th overall. But then if you look at perception, we are far ahead when it comes to perception. So we should be looking at how we can sell the positives. So in this case, if you're ahead, far ahead when it comes to perception, we should sell that, right? And you can put that in your resume too, because I'm pretty sure recruiters will be surprised. Oh, is it so? You're ranked 25th on perception, is it? We never knew that. Now that may be the response of a recruiter. Right, so it also helps to sell the
institute. So it will be helpful. Yes, sir. Showcase
especially if the recruiters are not from Tamil Nadu,
our country, maybe.
Yeah, from our state, they may definitely not know about GCT, right? So it is worth using such standards, mentioning about these standards, standard rankings.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I could get it.
Right. Fantastic. Any further questions, any further thoughts?
Sir, and many people question me that, is it necessary to put on a declaration under our resume?
Oh, no. So this is not a legal document, right?
Yes, sir.
Probably it's a historical tradition that we have followed. we used to do it, and I guess no need to declare. It's quite evident that whatever you say is supposed to be the truth and not falsehood. So you don't need to declare it. It's not a legal document. And you're actually wasting your space. And one more thing, when you talk of space, right, try to make sure that there aren't too many blank spaces on your resume. It doesn't look that good. When there are too many blank spaces on your resume, it gives an impression that you have nothing to say about yourself. Right? So it has to be compact. It need not be cramped where you filled in every part of the page. You don't need to do that. But then don't have a lot of blank spaces on your
resume. Sir, what would if I use a two column resume format?
See, format, it's up to you guys. You can use whatever format that suits you. No problems at all, right? As long as it looks good, reasonable rather, and then you convey all the content that you wish to convey in a single page, at most two pages, preferably a single page, at most two pages, right? Because some people do want to take it to two pages. It's perfectly fine, right? So format is never an issue, guys. Let's be very clear about it. Never an issue. Right?
Okay.
So what matters is the content and keep it packed.
Yeah.
So don't
in a logical order. Yeah. Like education first and then coming to your achievements, skills. You can also add your LinkedIn profile, maybe your link to your LinkedIn profile. So
absolutely. And if you're doing that, just make sure that you have your LinkedIn profile maintained. Because hypothetically, in an interview, they might say, okay, let me have a look at your LinkedIn profile, right? So if they were to do that, then it would be good if your LinkedIn profile is updated, right? And it will give a very good impression that, okay, you're a bit more professional in a way. So maintain your LinkedIn profile. It's literally a replica of your resume, right? Nothing different, correct? So whatever content is there in your resume, essentially can move into your LinkedIn profile. So maintain it. It's very, very important.
Okay, and it also shows how you're connected with, so it tells how collaborative you are, maybe with your alumni, with your staff, with your friends. So that's another perspective that generally recruiters look at sometimes, right? With the help of the LinkedIn.
True.
Very good.
Yes, ma'am.
So do you have any further questions?
I think I have got answer from all my questions, sir.
All right, fantastic. So those who are watching this video, this video will be, of course, available on our YouTube channel. And so there's a presentation that we had created. It goes by the title, I Am a Resume. So if you, it has a lot more details about how to construct a resume. And it also has a sample resume. And of course, as we said, you don't need to stick to that format. You can choose whatever format that you wish to use. But then, as long as you stick to the guidelines that we have mentioned in the presentation, it should be perfectly fine. So you should find the link to the presentation in the description section. Yeah, right. And you can have a look at it and feel free to comment or share your views on how this conversation went. This is our first attempt. We hope that we will be able to do more and bring in a lot more alumni for fruitful discussions. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.